What's the PMT function in Excel? Well, we use PMT to calculate the regular payments to be made on a loan, like maybe a car loan, mortgage, or so on, based on equal payments and a constant interest rate. To use PMT, we have to know the value of all loan payments now, which is the loan principal, the interest rate, and how many payment periods there'll be. After that, it's super easy to use. So let's say that we're getting a loan to buy a car. We want to borrow $12,000. The interest rate is 6.49% for 3 years. Since monthly payments are being made, we know that's 36 periods. So what'll our monthly payments be? We get inside this cell and let's get PMT to work it out. We type equals PMT, open parenthesis, and the first argument is rate, meaning the interest rate. Now it says 6.49%, but that's the annual interest rate. Since we're calculating payments by month, we have to use a monthly interest rate to make sure that we're comparing like with like. So we will reference this cell, B3, but we have to divide that by 12 months. We type a comma for the second argument, which is NPER. That's the number of periods, which will be 36. And comma for the next argument, which is PV, the present value of the loan. That's the amount of money we're getting, which is $12,000. The other two arguments, FV and type, are in square brackets, so they're not required. We'll come back to them later. Let's just see how PMT works with the basic arguments. So we can close parentheses now and enter. Here we go. Our monthly payments will be $367.73. Notice that this is shown as a negative amount. Remember that our loan principal was entered as a positive amount because it was money coming in to us. So the money we pay out is shown as a negative value. Obviously, this doesn't include any taxes or additional fees that the lender charges, but this is how easily Excel handles this type of question. Let's just label this so that we remember the name of each argument that the PMT function uses. So now, maybe you're curious about those two optional arguments, FV and type. FV stands for future value. Future value is another way of saying, what cash value do you want after the last payment is made? This is usually used in the case of investment accounts. If nothing is entered, future value is assumed to be zero. Type tells Excel whether payments are due at the beginning or the end of each period. Think of it as at the first of the month or the last of the month. If payments are expected at the beginning of a period, type a 1. That's pretty easy to remember. Otherwise, type a 0 or just omit that argument. Let's look at an example where we do use these optional arguments. Let's say that an interest rate of 7.5% is offered on 5-year investments. And we'd like to have $2,000 at the end of the 5 years. How much do we need to deposit each year? Well, our present value is 0 because there's no money in the investment account now. The number of periods is 5, since payments will be made once a year for 5 years. So let's start doing that with our PMT function. Our rate is 7.5%. There's no need to divide by 12 here because payments are only once per year. Number of periods, 5. Present value is 0. And the future value is 2,000. If payments are due at the end of the year, there's no need to enter the type. So let's close parentheses here. So this is the amount we'd need to deposit each year. Again, show it as a negative value because it's money we're paying out. $344.33. What if payments were due at the beginning of the year? Let's add a type as our last argument, and let's type the number 1 for the beginning of a period. So now our payments would be lower because interest is being applied earlier to the deposited amount. So the PMT function is very easy to use, and it is kind of cool. That's how Excel can simplify complex tasks for us. Learn more time-saving tips at GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.